हेलो राहुल जी, हाउ आर यू?
फाइन, थैंक यू. हाउ आर यू?
आई एम गुड. डिड यू एंजॉय योर डे ऑफ?
ऑफ कोर्स. आई स्लेप्ट, आई एट माय डिनर अर्ली, आई स्लेप्ट अर्ली.
सो व्हाट इज द टाइमिंग फॉर यू, लाइक बाय द क्लास एंड ओवर हियर, द इवनिंग क्लास, लाइक द अलाइनमेंट क्लास?
1:30 in the night.
Okay. Oh.
So there is
How
11
do you
o'clock,
manage?
here is 5:30.
That's like very pretty. Okay. Oh. Right.
Yeah, it's
difficult.
Yeah, it is actually. Means till 4 o'clock, normal school, and then after that, classes.
Okay. Oh. Okay. So you are a teacher.
Yeah. Wow. I am working
as. Which subject do you teach?
PE, physical education, physical and health education. So I teach PE as well as theory.
Okay, wow. For school kids or for college?
For school training? Kids. Yeah, I work for IB schools basically. It's an international curriculum.
Oh. Mm-hmm. Wow, awesome. That's nice. So, wait for 1-2 more minutes, I guess.
Yeah, we can wait, yeah.
Then we can start the class.
Yes. How was your break?
Yeah, it was refreshing, of course.
So your schedule is also full day. After this also you have classes, or like this is the only batch right now is running?
No. So this is for you guys of online classes go separately. We have and classes also, so students will go, so we have classes with them, those offline classes and then online classes, both.
Okay. So if suppose in the month of December I will come back to India, so if I want to go for 300 hours, so do you have any facilities to stay and do that program?
Yeah. So we have 28 day courses, and living and food and all, everything is over here only for those, like 28, 30 days.
Okay. And how much the charges for that?
Management. I'll connect you to the management. You can discuss that with them.
Mm-hmm.
So they'll be able to guide you when it comes
and
to
it's,
that.
And it's every month course, or it's like means particular after few months course, or so... If December, I will
every month.
Every month, okay.
No,
so every month.
New month.
Okay. So, suppose
200 hours.
Or,
300 hours every month.
So 300 hours also is 28 hours.
No, it's 28 days total.
28 days.
And you have a full day schedule, like from the morning. Till the evening, you are like you have classes.
Okay. And this accommodation is like the sharing basis or separate also?
The management, when you go for your booking, you can discuss with the management what you prefer, and they'll be able to guide you. Right.
Okay, means single accommodation and double accommodation both are available.
Yeah.
Okay.
So each month 200 hours, 300 hours starts like again. So new students come every month.
Okay. Like definitely face-to-face learning, it's better than online learning. Yes, you will learn more.
Definitely. The environment is also
different.
Environment,
yeah.
And everything.
In one batch, how many students at Morit?
Management. All of this is management department.
I will. Thank you so much for this. Yeah. These many inquiries.
Okay, so I think we will start the class. Yeah. So back in next trip. Gently close your eyes and start watching your breath. Natural flow of the breath. And come back to the present. Slowly and gently begin to elongate your breath. Inhalations, long, slow and deep exhalations. We'll chant Om three times, followed by three Shanti. After the next exhalation, inhale deeply for Om. Join both the palms together and chest, and drop both the palms together. Place them over the eyes. And slowly, while blinking and looking at the palm, open up eyes, come back to the smile, and namaste to everyone. Let's begin today's session. Okay. So, last time we talked about Patanjali Sutra. I thought that there are more stories about him because other stories as well, so I'll just forward that link on the group, like, because there are many more. Okay. So today our topic of discussion is Hatha Yoga, which the variation of Hatha Yoga which you guys have been practicing in your online classes, Ashtang Vinyas and Vinyas Yoga, came out of Hatha Yoga. So that is the practice that forms the foundation for all the other variations that come out of it. So Iyengar Yoga, all of these areas which are going on the basic practice or I can say they have this the entire, like all other variations came out. So, and you will also see that other forms that you learn are either therapeutic forms or they are flow forms. But when you see the practice of Hatha Yoga, it focuses mainly on extreme stability of the body. So you will go in a particular asana and you will hold over there. So according to Hatha Yoga, holding and gaining mastery over asana is important. So, and how do you gain mastery? By holding in that asana. No flow when you go into Hatha Yoga. There is holding, because Hatha Yoga believes that that practice, the system of all of those practices is to support Raj Yoga or your meditation and your spiritual journey. So attaining stability in a posture is very important. Okay. So that is why when you do postures according to Hatha Yoga practices, you will see there is very long holding in each and every asana. Okay. So right now, because you are doing flow and moving with each count, you are taking one breath. So in Hatha Yoga also, when you go in a particular asana, there is a breath pattern. And once you reach that asana, you breathe normally, or in some asanas, you hold your breath and just stay over there. Okay. So very interesting style of yoga to experience once again. Requires a lot of patience and a lot of, I would say, faith. Because when you are in an asana and it gets painful, it's your belief in the practice which keeps you going. So let's just discuss the word hatha first, because asana, as we have discussed, asana is a main part, but there are other practices also, hatha. So let me come to the word hat. So it's written as H-A-T-H-A, hatha, I can say. Yeah. So I'll just write this down. So in this word is divided into ha, which means the right side, I'm writing down the various meanings of the word here. Okay, so it's the right side, and it denotes the sun part. Okay, so there is like a part which is energizing you, like, so the right side, so the right nostril is associated with the ha part, and the pingla nadi. We'll talk about nadis also, so then I will explain. Then tha is means the left side. Moon or the Ida Nadi. Okay. So, as the word itself constitutes both right and left, so, in front of that, we put yo. So, it means when the right and left is balanced. Okay. So Hatha Yoga is when you are able to balance your Ida and Pingla Nadi, and then what starts happening is the energy flows through the Sushumna Nadi. So there are three main nadis that we have: Ida, Pingla, and Sushumna. Okay. And in spiritual practice, is considered very important nadi, because when energy flows through that nadi, there is a lot of spiritual growth. For the sake of music, this is all we need to know. That's also we have discussed about nadis and like the energy channels.
Can you please
your voice is
actually your voice is cutting, actually breaking different places. About when you were telling about
Rahul ji, am I audible to you? Okay, I'll do that again. But I just want to ensure before that my voice is breaking for everyone. Or am I audible to all other students?
No, everything was audible, but the nadi part when you told about the three nadis, so that got there was a voice disturbance.
Okay. So in pranayam class, we have discussed about nadis and how they are subtle channels that are in our body. So these subtle channels. So there are 72,000 nadis in your body, okay? 72,000. 36,000 for one side and 36 for the other side, okay? So what happens is that now there are so many nadis, but there are a few nadis which are important out of these, okay, for your spiritual growth. So those three nadis are Ida, Pingla and Sushumna nadi, three nadis. So as I've written in the chat box also, Ida and Pingla I have written in the chat box also. I will just spell that out. So Pingla, or the part which represents Ha of the Hatha, is P-I-N-G-A-L-A, Pingla. And Tha is represented by the Ida nadi, which is I-D-A. Okay. So these three nadis are very important. And what happens is once you attain balance in Ida and Pingla, or your right side and the left side, then the energy starts to flow through the center nadi, the main nadi, which is the Sushumna nadi. Okay. And when energy flows through the Sushumna nadi, you will see that that is very important for your spiritual growth. Okay. Before that,
can you please spell the alphabets of that third nadi? The center Sushumna. One.
Yes. I will write it down also and I will spell it also.
Okay.
Sushumna. S-U-S-H-U-M-N-A. Sushumna nadi. Okay.
So all this 72,000 nadis are connected to each other, or?
So all of these nadis are like, it's like the veins and arteries in your body. It's okay. Kind of the same thing, but these are subtle channels.
Okay.
So when you must have looked at a diagram, like I don't know how to make it on Zoom for you, but if I have the option of whiteboard. Okay. So you must have seen this. There's a straight line, and then we see that this goes like this. Yeah, my drawing isn't very good right now. So, and there is this one. Actually, this is a junction. Wait, let me erase all of it and try to make it again. there's a straight line, and then you see that this, there are more junction points also, but for the sake of simplicity and understanding for now.
This is the diagram of?
I'm telling you. So the right side is represented by the Pingala Nadi. Okay. Left side is Ira Nadi. And this is the Sushumna Nadi. So sorry for this, like, but yeah, so these junction points of Ida and Pingala, these are the chakras. You must have heard of chakras these days. The whole concept is very famous also. Chakra meditation, a lot of things related to chakras are famous. So the point of intersection of Ida, Pingala and Sushumna is where a major energy center is formed. And that major energy center is what? It's a chakra. Okay, so there are 7 main chakras in the body. Apart from that, once again, like, we have so many nadis, and these are the 3 main nadis. So we have a lot of chakras in the body, and there are 7 main chakras that are generally talked of. So the intersection points of the main nadis form the main chakras. Okay. I'll stop sharing this. It was just an image for you guys, like, to get an idea. Okay. So when the energy is flowing through either Ida or Pingala, the Sushumna Nadi cannot be activated. Okay. So once the energy is not flowing through both of them, then the energy goes through the Sushumna Nadi. So you must have noticed during your day also, when you are breathing, just observe this. During the day when you are breathing, one nostril will be more dominant than the other one. Okay. So if my right nostril is more dominant, that means that my Pingala Nadi is active at that point of time. If my left nostril is more active, during a particular time, so my Ida Nadi will be more active. Okay, and there is a particular point during the day when you might feel that both of your nostrils are working at the same level, like inhalation and exhalation is taking place equally through both the nostrils. That is the point when Sushumna is activated. It's for a few seconds only during the day, but all of us experience activation of Sushumna Nadi for a very brief period of time during the day, every day. But what the yogi does is he tries to elongate this time, because he knows that the energy has to travel from down to up, and it will only travel from down to up, like, for his purpose, through the Sushumna Nadi. Okay, so I've just said a mouthful of things about nadis, Ida, Pingala, Sushumna, chakras. A lot of words have been used. So, any doubts related to these things? Okay.
So, during pranayam, we activate this nadis, or it's all itself activated?
So through hatha yogic practices, asana, pranayama, I will come to what comes in hatha yogic practices. So during hatha yogic practices, the aim is to balance both of them and then take that energy through Sushumna. So pranayama is a part of hatha yoga.
Okay.
So
okay.
Over there also, trying to balance.
Is it also like that one nadi is active and the other is not? So there is some imbalance or some, like, what is it? There are different working styles of both the nadis or something?
I'll tell you what each activation of each nadi does. So of course there is an imbalance, because that is why we are doing Hatha Yoga, right? Because we need to balance out both of them. So it does cause an imbalance in the body, and then we experience that in different ways, like you stress a lot, or you lose flexibility. There is like blockage in the body. So I won't say you lose flexibility, but energy blockages are formed in the body. They give rise to diseases. So all of these things like are happening on an energetic level. So not only is it physiological, like for example, like a lot of people believe that if you are able to unblock the energy in a particular point, so that disease also dissolves away. So on an energetic level, there is an imbalance for all of us right now. And that is what you are working towards. Okay, so I'll move ahead. So the Pingala Nadi is associated with your sympathetic nervous system. So whenever I'm in like an active mode, I will see that my right nostril is working and I'm able to be active. The left nostril is associated with your parasympathetic nervous system. In pranayam class, we have discussed both the systems and their own functions. So parasympathetic system is related to your relaxation. When you go to sleep, your left nostril once again gets activated. So it helps the body to relax. Both of them have their own roles. Yes. So we have different pranayams also. Like if you will see Surya Bhedan pranayam. So we inhale through the right nostril, exhale through the left nostril. We will cover all of this in pranayam class. I'm just giving you a brief. Okay, so there we are working on activating ourselves. So people who feel very lethargic can go for Surya Bhedan Pranayam. If they activate their right nostril, then they will be able to do all the work that they are feeling lazy about. And it goes the other way around also. If you're very stressed, so you can practice Chandra Bhedan Pranayam, where you inhale through your left, exhale through your right. Okay, and in this way, you are able to relax yourself much more. Like if my mind, state of mind is not, I can say I'm feeling very stressed, then I can practice Chandra Bhedan Pranayam and activate my Ida Nadi. Okay, so these are the specific functions that are associated with both the nadis, and the practice of Hatha Yoga once again is to balance both out so that you prepare yourself for Raj Yoga. So let's okay, I'll just switch off my video. Okay. So, So let's discuss, like, when we talk of Hatha Yoga, what are the practices that come under the Hatha Yoga texts? Like, what are the practices that are given? So, first we'll come to the main text that is associated with Hatha Yoga. And that text is called Hatha Yoga Pradipika. I'll just write this down in the chat box also. H-A-P-H-A, Hatha, Yoga, Y-O-G-A, and Pradipika, P-R-A-D-I-P-I-K-A, Hatha Yoga Pradipika. So this is your first point. This should be your first point of reference when you are going for to understand what Hatha Yoga is and what are the practices that come in Hatha Yoga. So when this text was written, like then the need of only a few things was seen. Okay, as the time moved ahead, then we get one more text, which is called Bhairan Sahita. And that text is like, that text you will see has more practices because the time changed and it was seen that to attain the same amount of stability in the body and the mind, now more practices had to be done. Okay, so I'll just write this down. So Bhairan Sahita is spelled as G H E R A N D A, and then Sahita is spelled as S A M H I T A. So this is the second text that you can refer to when you are going into Hatha Yoga practices. So one more thing, Hatha Yoga has this very strong belief that the mind and your body has a very strong connection. So as we have discussed in earlier classes also, when we go for Hatha Yoga, Yam and Niyam are not emphasized upon. Okay. The main emphasis of Hatha Yoga is to attain stability in your body so that you can come to the point where it's easier for you to follow certain mental rules also, or certain rules which will help to enhance your life, but they require a lot of willpower. So when you go to Hatha Yoga Pradipika, there are four chapters in this text. The first one is asana. So A, S, A, N, A, asana. Then we have pranayama. Then we have mudra anban. Okay, so we reached mudra and band. Now the last chapter is nad anusandhan. So N A D A, nad, and anusandhan, A N U S A N D H A N A. Okay.
Sorry, but you said the asanas, pranayams, and the third and fourth one is?
Mudra and band is the third one. And Nad Anusandhan is the fourth chapter.
Okay.
Did you get the spelling of Nad Anusandhan?
Yes.
Yes.
Okay.
So all this text, it's available in that PDF?
No. So these are separate books. Like, okay. We are right now discussing about the book. What is the book? What does it have? This is a basic introduction. These books are proper texts in themselves.
Okay, okay.
So you'll have to read them separately. So there is a commentary by Bihar School of Yoga on Hatyogpradipika. It's a pretty good book, like a proper explanation has been given. So you guys can look for that. It is a red colored book.
Can you tell me the name again? Hatyog?
Hatyogpradipika. The name of the book is the same, but it's a commentary by Bihar School of Yoga.
Okay, okay.
It's a red colored book. You can just type this on Google and you will be able to find this easily.
Okay, okay. Thank you.
Yeah. Okay, so these are the four chapters. So in the first chapter, 15 asanas have been talked of. Total asanas in Hatyogpradipika are 15. Then we come to pranayama. So 8 pranayamas have been talked of. But before starting with pranayama, they have talked of the shatkarmas. Okay, so the shatkarmas have been discussed in the second chapter before the practice of pranayama is discussed. And as per Hatyogpradipika, you will go into the practice of Shatkarma only and only if the three doshas in your body are not balanced. If they are balanced, there is no need for you to practice Shatkarma. Then we come to the pranayama part we have done. There are 8 pranayamas. Then you go into mudras and bandhas. So that is a separate chapter, and multiple mudras and bandhas have been discussed. So it goes very deep, and until pranayama discussion is okay, but mudra and bandh don't go very deep. Those are very advanced practices. So once you attain stability in asana and then in pranayama, then go into mudras and bandhas. And the last chapter is Nad Anusandhan. So as per Hatyogpradipika, one can attain the final goal through the practice of Nad Anusandhan. The entire technique has been defined in the book itself. So once again, that is after mudra and bandha, so very advanced practice. So these are the 4 Hatyogic practices as per Hatyogpradipika. And out of the 15 asanas that are given, 4 asanas are considered to be the most important ones because they are meditative postures, and those will help you to move ahead in your sadhana, spiritual practice. Okay. Let's come to Gherin Sahita. So Gherin Sahita was written later on. So you will see that it has 7 chapters in all. In total, there are 7 chapters in Gherin Sahita. And it starts with the practice of Shatkarma. So the first chapter that you will see in Gherin Sahita is Shatkarma. Then, so the concept of Saptang Yog can be found in Gherin Sahita. In Hatyogpradipika, we have Chaturang. So there are 4 practices that have been given. But in Gherin Sahita, there are 7 practices in all that have been given. So it's called Saptang Yog. seven limbs. So you don't need to write all of them. That is why I'm not writing these specific names in the chat box. Just for your extra knowledge, I'm giving you this information. You don't need to go in that. So we start with Shatkarma. Then we come to the practice of asana. The second chapter is asana. There are a total of 32 asanas that have been discussed. So from 15, as the time shifted, the number of asanas to attain that same level of stability were now 32 asanas. Then we have Bandha and Mudra. The third chapter is Bandha and Mudra. Then we go to the fourth chapter and we have Pratyahar. Then the next chapter is Pranayam. Fifth chapter is Pranayam. Then the sixth chapter is Dhyan. And your last chapter is Samadhi. Okay. So this text has been written in the form of a conversation. So when you read this text, there is a conversation style that is going on. The question is being asked and then the question and tries to explain the various practices that are that will help. So you can say all of these practices come under the Hatha Yoga also, like in Hatha Yoga texts also practices like Pratyahar have been discussed. Okay, so any doubt so far in the two texts that we have talked of? Okay. Okay, great. So, yeah. Somebody unmuted. So, any doubts?
No doubts.
Okay. So, for Gheran Sahita also, you will find a commentary by Bihar School of Yoga. It's a thick book. And I think this book is also red in color. And they give, apart from the translation of the shlokas, they give a proper explanation of what is being talked of. So, going for that book is much better than going for other books. So, there are other books also, but it would be a thin book.
So if you... name of the book?
Google.
Your voice Gheran is breaking.
Okay. Was it better? Hello.
Your voice is breaking. So.
Hello.
Can you hear me?
How is it? Yeah, I can hear you. Can you hear me?
Yeah, I can hear you. Okay. Can you tell me the
name of Gheran Sahita only and the commentary by Bihar School of Yoga?
Okay. Thank you.
Okay. I hope there are the names of the books are clear. And the practices of Hatha Yoga are also a little bit more clear. Now we have a greater understanding of what Hatha Yoga in general is. and why you are practicing Hatha Yoga. So when you read Hatha Yoga Pradipika also, in the beginning only, he says, okay. Where did my wife? You guys able to hear me?
Yes, yes. So we will follow the Graham Samhita now, like one is Hatha Yoga Pradipika and the other one is this Graham Yoga Samhita. So we will follow this one.
Sorry, can you repeat this one more time, the question?
Yeah, actually there are two this Hatha Yoga. One is Hatha Yoga Pradipika and the other one is Graham Samhita. So now we will follow this Graham Samhita, like in pranayams and asanas.
Okay, so yoga is in modern life with Vinyas Yoga. So if you are going into very deep sadhana, then go for Hatha Yoga. But and read these texts because so in like if you go for Hatha Yoga Pradipika, there are 15 asanas. So each and every one of them has to be mastered. But I can say that they're not consuming food and there are a lot formed in the body. So you will see even those 15 asanas when you see, then we need a lot of pre-practices to reach where we are able to perfect all 15 of them. So for us, the modern day practices are much more, I would say, practical. And then you can reach to a point where all the Hatha yogic asanas you perfect. Then go to the next limb, which is pranayam. So you can read these texts to understand Hatha yoga better. What Hatha yoga is trying to say or what are the practices that one can do. But those practices were very easily, or at least it was less difficult for them to achieve because of the food and the environment they existed in. For us, our whole environment is so different. We live in cities and consume packed, packaged foods. So all of those things have an impact on the body. So it's harder to reach that same point.
Okay.
Mm-hmm. So read them, set them as your target. But don't forget your body. However you think, like do pre-practices, try to open up your body as much as possible so that you can, those are your final goals, basically achieving those practices, because very advanced practices are given, like Kukut Asana, Paschimottan Asana. All of these asanas are like I would say advanced level. Like in the way they have been described, they are very advanced level. So it takes a lot of years of practice to reach that point.
Yeah, right, right. Actually, we did the sun salutation. I was not able to do the perfect pose in that even. So those are far away to reach, I think.
Exactly. So for us, these modern styles that have come up are more practical than following the proper Hatha yogic texts. So start with these, start with basic and very, like, work on very small body parts. So do mobility exercises more so that your body starts to open up, and then go into the position of asanas, and eventually you will reach a point where you will be able to perfect that asana. So that level of perfection has been talked of when the asanas of Hatha Yoga Pradipika are discussed. Okay. So any other doubts that you guys have?
Yeah.
No other doubts? Okay.
No,
so
all is clear.
So today you can go research more about this. And if you come across something you don't understand, please feel free to ask in the future classes. And okay, so we can...
Second book I didn't find.
Parent Saita is harder to find, yes. You can find the commentary of Kevalya Dham very easily.
Okay, because Hatha Yoga Pradapika I found. I downloaded it also.
Go for Kevalya Dham's commentary on Saita. You will find direct translations. But the book is available online. So if you order the book online, you will find Gheran Saita or Gheran Saita's commentary.
Okay. If here I will book better, I can come there, collect and come back.
Yeah. Because
so Amazon online... will take 1 month time.
Exactly. So even I was trying to find for an online, look for an online copy of Gheran Saita, but it's not available so far. That one is not available. So go for Kevalya Dham's commentary.
Okay.
Yeah, that you'll be able to find it. Okay.
Thank you.
So let's end today. Everybody just sit up straight, back neck straight, gently close your eyes. Observe your breath. We'll chant Om one time, followed by three Shantis. Inhale deeply for Om. Shanti, Shanti, Shanti. Join both your palms together in front of your chest. Bow down. And remember, any one incident from your past 24 hours that you are grateful for, say a mental thank you. And now rub both the palms together. Place them over your eyes. And very slowly, while blinking and looking at your palms, open up your eyes, come back with a smile, and namaste to everyone. I will see you for your pranayama namaste. Class.
Thank you.
Thank you so much. Bye-bye. Bye.